46 years he has done ag statistics. 46 years, is that correct? And he's going to give us an update of the latest statistics. So I'm going to turn it over to Jim.
Thank you, Director Zeringer. We'll just get started right away with the update from the progress report that was released on Monday afternoon. The report date was as of Sunday, May 22nd. At that point in Ohio, we had 11% of the corn crop planted. Normally by that date, we would have 80% planted.
Mr. Ramey, can't hear you very well.
And corn emerged on that date was 2%. Normally 58% would be emerged. Soybeans planted, 4%. That's 50 points behind the normal of 54%. Soybeans emerged, 1%, normally 26%. Alfalfa hay for cutting, which is becoming a concern, 3% is complete. Normally we would have had 11%. And that's going to just get worse in the next few days and weeks. In the history of the Ohio Crop Progress Report, planting of corn in Ohio has never been as far behind. 69 points behind the five-year average and 76 points behind last year, which was really kind of a bad year for planting. The data from this report was collected on Friday, May 20th, and then it was normalized to the May 22nd date. That's the way we normally handle the data that we collect. They are collected on the computer. Most of the reporters respond on their computers, so we get the data in a fairly short time frame when we collect it. We don't let them start until we want them to, and then we shut them off when we want it shut off. So not everybody that's on the list reports every week, but we had good responses last week. And we normally do when there are weather conditions that are affecting the crops. When I look back, our records go back to about 1960 for the crop progress and the plantings. And back in 1960, I don't know, some of you will remember that the cultural practices for planting corn were considerably different from now because they had to plow the ground first. And then they put the corn in, and as a result, in those times, corn planting was a little bit later than we normally expect today. But even this year, we're behind those dates. In other states, on May 22nd, our next closest one that is far behind was Pennsylvania. They were 34% behind normal. Remember, we were 69%. Our good friends to the west, Indiana, 27 points behind normal. Kentucky and Michigan were both 25% or points behind normal. Wisconsin, 19 points behind. Minnesota was 12. And Iowa was 4 points ahead of normal. Illinois was 5 points ahead of normal. Missouri, 6 points ahead of normal. In the U.S., we normally report 18 states. Those states accounted for 92% of the corn planted in the U.S. last year. And overall, when it's weighted by the acreage that was put in, we're nationally about 8 points behind normal. One of the questions I ask myself is how fast can planting progress if we could get started right away? Normally, the corn planting window is 10 to 15 weeks. That's when we see progress from beginning to end on corn planting, from 0% to 100%. The most progress that I was able to find in any one week in any one year was 47% planted in 1 week in Ohio. So that was kind of an anomaly though. More normally, it would be 24 to 28% in 1 week. And so you would think, well, we can get corn planted in 4 weeks. Well, that doesn't normally happen that way because I've never found any year where we had 2 weeks consecutively that had 20% or more. Normally, if we have more than 20% 1 week, we'll drop under 10% the next week. So we still are a ways away, and the farmers certainly are going to have to wait for their fields to dry out before they can even start. And I'm using corn as kind of an example of what's going on. I know there are a number of other crops that are being delayed by this, and but corn is a good foil for almost all of them. What's NASH going to do about all of this in terms of reporting? Well, we have a normal progress or normal progression of surveys through the year. Back in March, we did the intentions report where farmers reported their intentions to plant. In June, we always do an area survey. Now, that area survey consists of 640-acre land segments throughout the state. There are 196 of those that we visit. Normally, we'll find about 1,000 farms in those 196 land segments, at least part of those farms, and we collect the data then from those farms that we have there. When we collect the data on those segments, we have to account for every acre in every field in each of those segments to find out what's being produced there or what's planned to be produced. And for each field, the producers are asked how many acres are to be planted or are planted. Then they're asked how many acres of the field have yet to be planted, and that's kind of key for us. From these data and data from other surveys, NASH will produce estimates of the number of corn acres planted and to be planted for each crop. The estimates will be published on June 30th, 2011. That's our normal schedule. It's been published since last November. The reference date for the survey is June 1, and that is fairly critical. Data will be collected for that survey between May 28th and June 14th. It takes us about 2 weeks to collect that data. When the data are collected, we will evaluate how much of that acreage is yet to be planted and make a determination whether we need to do a follow-up to find out how much of it actually got planted. Our objective in all of this is by the end of the year to know how many acres were actually planted, how many acres actually got harvested, and how much production was actually produced. So we're not too concerned at this point about getting the acreage right. We have time to do that, and we will have several surveys that help us do that. If is determined that we're too much not planted, we will go back to these producers that indicated that they had fields left to be planted or acreage left to be planted to find out from them what they actually did plant. How much of it was planted to the crop that they intended to plant it to, how much was planted to something else, and how much was not planted at all. And then we'll go in and make some adjustments on the planted acres based on what we find there. Now, historically, NASA has done this. This is part of the normal thing. In June of 2008, if you remember, there was extensive flooding in the Midwest along the major rivers that caused several problems. One, it delayed some plantings. Other places, it caused replanting, both to the same crop or to a different crop. And then in some cases, it wiped out the fields and they never did plant. But in the June 30th report, this is what it said. Extensive rains and flooding during June caused producers in several Midwestern states to change their harvesting intentions for crops already planted. Modify planting decisions for small percentage of acres not yet planted, and consider replanting options. NASA collected most of the data for the annual acreage report before the majority of the flooding occurred in an effort to more accurately determine how many acres producers still intend to harvest for grain. Some of that was... published in the June 30th report. Some of the adjustments were already made there. They continued to collect data then through July and made some of the final adjustments with the August crop report when we first put out the forecast of what the yield and production is going to be for the year. So by August, we should have the actual planted acres in hand and be ready to report.
Thank you very much, Jim. And for bottom line, 11%, 11% Ohio is just by nodding the heads. Is that about what everybody feels their county? I know Terry's going to talk a little bit about maybe how every county's looking in particular, but about 11% is a pretty good feel.
Director, that does not take in any, that does not take into account any planning or that occurred on last weekend, really. We tried to make some adjustments for it, but it we'll have to see where we went this week when we do it.
And as we'll hear from Representative Peterson in a little bit, there are quite a few that did get a lot of stuff socked in last weekend in that very short window. And like you said, Jim, we can do a lot of work if we have a little time. So, and again, when you get those pesky reporting calls from this guy's office, these statistics are very, very important. So thank you very much.